Hi, I'm Margaret Martin, and I currently have a practice in Ottawa, Ontario, which is in Canada. My practice as a sole practitioner allows me to work with clients one-on-one. I have an hour with each client, each session, and mainly this is a practice that I've chosen to have after having worked in so many different hospital and clinic settings, from Newfoundland across to Vancouver, down to California, and ultimately I felt in order to have the quality of practice that I want to have, this is what I've chosen to do. My decision to become a physical therapist was unfortunately not one that had a lot of forethought to it. I had studied health sciences and was speaking with fellow students as to what the next step they were going to take in their career path, and several of them were applying to the School of Physical Therapy at McGill, and I thought, wow, that actually sounds quite interesting. And it didn't involve any needles at the time. I didn't know about the acupuncture components of it. And so that was my application, was to the School of Physical Therapy. And I've been blessed with having had the fortune of being guided in the right direction. What I love the most about my practice as a physical therapist, and my practice through the past 27 years, has been the ability to empower somebody to have a little bit more understanding of how their body works and to allow them to have a little more freedom of motion or a little more comfort in their day-to-day life. My very first mentor was Dr. Edith Aston at McGill University, who taught me that the art of physical therapy was just as important as the science of physical therapy. Since then, I would have to say that my mentors are the therapists that I get to interact with and teach, whether it's one-on-one, or who take the online course and then correspond with me either through an ongoing webinar or an email, and they bring forth their challenges out in the field in osteoporosis, and I'm just in awe with these therapists with how they have to, you know, work in such a busy practice, and they may be looking at, you know, a shoulder dysfunction or a knee dysfunction, but underlying that, they also have to look at the skeletal health of that individual and just their ability to pull things together. And I've actually learned a lot from them over my years at teaching the Melio Guide course. And one of the most fascinating things about the course is that the course doesn't just cover one aspect of physical therapy practice, but rather it touches upon all therapists in all their practice areas, be it pediatrics, be it oncology, geriatrics, underlying all of the aspects of or challenges that you're faced as a therapist, the skeletal health of your client is utmost of importance. Well, I guess some people might think exercise is fun, and I'm one of those individuals, so when I have an opportunity, my fun is usually involving hiking or biking or extra Tai Chi practice or going to a different class that I haven't been exposed to. Generally, my fun involves learning different movement patterns for myself and just exploring movement, because that's something that I really love to do. Most people don't know that I come from a family of 11 children, and I'm the eighth of that family, and large French-Canadian family, and so that's kind of a unique characteristic of mine.